Today's class, we are going to measure the various cutting forces in turning process. Okay? The aim of this experiment is to measure the cutting forces for the given cutting conditions. The what are the tools required and also what are the equipments required means, first the lathe is required, then after that lathe tool dynamometer. It is an instrument which is used to measure the cutting forces. It's the lathe tool dynamometer. So how to proceed this means, first the lathe tool dynamometer is initially set to zero, that is PX and PZ conditions was set to zero. That is PX is the axial component that will act in the direction of the tool traverse, and it is at right angles to PZ. Okay, so it contributes very little to the power consumption. Then PY is the radial component. It will act along the tool sand and perpendicular to the other two components. It has no share in the power consumption. Whereas the PZ is the main or tangential component. It determines, it finds out the torque on the main drive mechanism, the deflection of the tool, and the required power. So this component acts in the direction of the cutting speed. How to proceed means, first after setting the lathe tool dynamometer initially to zero condition, the depth of cut and the RPM was selected. Now the selected RPM is 345 RPM and the feed rate given is 10 mm per minute. The depth of cut is 0.1 mm. See? Now the cutting is going on, measuring is taking place. At the same time, you see the lathe tool dynamometer, the readings are coming. That is PX is the axial component. It will act in the direction of the tool traverse and it is at the right angles to PZ. So it contributes very little to the power consumption. That is PZ. See? It is a main or tangential component. Now the readings are varying from PX is maximum 4 and whereas PZ is maximum of 25. Okay. Now the depth of cut is increased to 0.2 mm. The depth of cut is increased 0.2 mm with the same RPM and feed rate of 10 mm per minute. Now you see the readings in the lathe tool dynamometer. That is in PX is maximum of 5, whereas in PZ is 16. Till it goes, even 24, 30 it reaches. Okay, 6 and 30. Okay, this reading was noted in the tabular column. So after recording these details, now the depth of cut is increased to 0.3 mm. Depth of cut is increased 0.3 mm. With the same RPM of 345 RPM and 10 mm per minute of feed rate, only the changing is depth of cut 0.3 mm. Now you see the reading. Maximum 4 and 15. Even 7. 20. There is 3 axis 7. 3 digit is 20. You can record this 3x and 3z in the doubler column. Then you can square the px and also the pz. Then you can find out the resultant force. R is equal to some others tell it is p. So R is equal to square root of px squared plus pz squared. Repeatedly you can take 3 readings and you can make it as an, or you can find the average of these 3 readings. Okay. So from this, what we are concluding means, what's the result we are obtaining means, the cutting forces that will be measured by using the different depth of cut. Especially here we are using 0.1 mm depth of cut, 0.2 mm depth of cut and 0.3 mm depth of cut. So you can record it in the doubler column. Okay, this is the doubler column. So from this, what we are concluding is the various cutting forces are measured by using the different depth of cuts. Okay, thank you students, thank you.